Greetings and praise the Lord. Welcome to today's devotion. And we have started on the reassurance. We are now on the second episode, which is on healing and forgiveness. I would ask you to invite each and everyone so that they hear what the Lord is saying this day. In Matthew chapter 9, verses 1 to 7, I'm reading from the New King James Version. So he got into a boat, that is Jesus, crossed over and came to his own city, and that is Capernaum. Then behold, they brought to him a paralytic lying on a bed. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, be of good cheer, your sins are forgiven you." And at once some of the scribes said within themselves, "This man blasphemes." But Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, "Why do you think evil in your hearts? For which is easier, to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Arise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has power and on earth to forgive sins," then he said to the paralytic, "Arise, take your bed and go to your house." And he arose and departed to his house. But when the crowd saw this, they were awestruck, or they were afraid. And they glorified God who had given such authority to men. We thank God that the Lord Jesus, we are told that he had to cross over from wherever he was in a boat. He used the boat, crossed over and came to Capernaum. That means that Jesus had moved from Nazareth and moved to Capernaum. Then behold, we are told that there was a paralytic man that was brought lying on a bed by his friends. And Jesus saw their faith. And because of the faith of these friends, of this paralytic, Jesus told this paralytic, "Be of good cheer." You see, Jesus will not look at you and ignore you, or just look at you and just treat you like just as someone with a disability, or just mishandle you. But when he sees you and he sees the situation you're in, he has to raise you from that situation to another. That is why you need to allow yourself to be in the presence of God, so that he will see you. It doesn't mean that when you're not in his presence, he doesn't see you. No, he does. But when you come to his presence, you are clearly visible in the presence of God, because that is where you cause God to act in a different manner than when you're not in his presence. When you're in his presence, you are able to have your eyes open to see that which belongs to you, and that which is going to be a blessing to you, that which is going to bring promotion and expansion to you. But when you are not close by, you will not see or receive that which the Lord has for you. In the presence of the Lord, there is healing. In the presence of God, there is a forgiveness of sins. In the presence of the Lord, we walk in humility. And when you walk in humility, there is something that takes place in our lives. We are raised. We are promoted. And that is what happened. This man, he wasn't brought to stay up there on high, but he was brought and he was lowered to right where Jesus was. And Jesus cannot ignore someone who has come to us such a level. A paralytic man, even if he was in a bed, it was lower than he was right down in the presence of God. And we are told that, you know what, Jesus will always have the word of encouragement. And that is why our topic this time is reassurance. The Lord telling us, "I'm not leaving you. I'm going to be with you until the end of time. I will be with you forever and ever. I will be with you until you overcome. I will be with you until you receive your healing. I will be with you until you get delivered. I will be with you until all your chains are broken. I will be with you until you move to a level you never imagined. This is the Lord. That is what he does. When he saw this man that was paralytic, we are told he told him to cheer. And he was told, why is he supposed to cheer? It is because his sins are forgiven. What is so special about the sins being forgiven? And if you are there, you are not asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins and have your name written in the book of life, this is the best time to do so. Because when you do not have, you can be healed and not have your sins forgiven. When people get healed, that doesn't mean that they have been forgiven. You have to be available and you have to admit that you are a sinner. So this man, because of the humility that was in him, the Lord told him that his sins have been forgiven. That is greater than other physical miracles. Why? Because it is through the forgiveness of sin that we'll be able to see God our Father and be with him eternally. Because if we do not have sins, it doesn't matter how healed we are or how blessed we are. We imagine without the forgiveness of sins, you cannot see God. And you know what? Without the forgiveness of sins, there are so many things that are going to happen because you will not obtain favor with God and man. So that is why it is very important to have your sins forgiven. And we are told, and you know what? As he was told this, the scribes were not happy about it. They say that he is blaspheming. But this is what Jesus told them because he knew their thoughts. He knew their hearts. He told them, which is easier to you? Your sins are forgiven you? Or to say, arise and walk. But that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins. Then he said to the paralytic, arise, take up your bed and go to your house. And he arose and departed to his house. But when the crowd saw him, you know, and that is what, you know what? Jesus first wants you people to learn something from what he's doing and even what he's saying. You have to be very attentive to the voice, because when you hear what God has said, you are not going to demand for those miracles. But many people are demanding for miracles. And you know what? Once we have been given the assurance that our sins are forgiven, that is the best reward you can receive. That is the best thing, because that caused Jesus to die on the cross so that we can have our sins forgiven as we continue to have our eyes open to admit and allow him to cleanse us and have our names written in the book of life. We are told that this man, when he was told, arise, take up your bed and go to your house. And that is what happened. And any time when Jesus performs a miracle, what we need to do is to glorify the Lord. And that is exactly what these people did. They glorified the Lord who had given such authority to man. Because Jesus came as a man. He was God, but he came as a man, so that we is able to experience what we are experiencing. Because we will not be saying, you know what, he's telling us to get saved and he doesn't know the pain we are in. He knows all manner of pain that you have, and that is why he will forgive you your sins. In Jeremiah 33 verse 6, also from, no, this one is from New American Standard Bible. Behold, I am going to bring to it healing and a remedy, and I will heal them. And I will reveal to them an abundance of peace and truth. An abundance of peace and truth. Why? Because there is healing. There is remedy. The Lord is healing us. And when he is healing us, there is something he does with us. He gives us a revelation. He reveals to us what he has. When he has brought healing into our lives, our eyes are healed and we can open them and see the abundance of peace and truth. Because without peace, without truth, we cannot survive. And that is why we need to be assured that our sins have been forgiven and our names written in the book of life. Then in Isaiah 38 verse 16, from New American Standard Bible, Lord, by these things people live, and in all this is the life of my spirit. Restore me to health and let me live. Behold, for my own welfare I had great bitterness, but you have kept my soul from the pit of nothingness, and you have held all my sins behind my back. That is what the Lord does. He holds all your sins behind your back. He takes away your sins, and they are thrown into the sea of forgetfulness, because the Lord wants us to even forget, so that we are able to continue with the journey and accomplish that which God has set before us. May the Lord bless you for now as you continue to do great and mighty things in the presence of God. Now that you are encouraged, you are told, do not be afraid. You have been told to cheer up, so that you know that your sins are also forgiven, because that is what the Lord is telling us. God bless you for now. Log into our website at www.agracem.org and become a partner. At the same time, become a blessing into our lives as we continue to be a blessing to you as you hear this word. And also, follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and also YouTube. And it is Bishop Dr. Grace Kariuki. And please be there, supportive, and share, like, subscribe, and even let others know the great feast that you are enjoying in this place. Be blessed for now. I look forward to hear from you, and even your comments, I'm reading them, and it's been such a joy to hear how people are learning things every day on this platform. For now, may the Lord bless you, and look forward to be with you again. Shalom, shalom. This is Bishop Dr. Grace Kariuki of Amazing Grace International Ministries.